Hey guys. Back again with another episode of Dark Souls here. I am going to investigate the Darkroot Garden today, I believe. I'm going to use the fact that I have sorcery as a way to make this fight a little bit easier. I don't have to get close enough to him, apparently. Don't want him to jump on me. Well, this is not doing much damage at all, I guess. Normally, if I was doing a sorcery playthrough here, I would be leveling up in. Keeping it at 15. Wow, I staggered him! Anyway, this is a Titanite demon. He's related to the Titanite slabs. They used to be statues made out of Titanite, I guess. His head is cut off. I think that's for the, they mentioned earlier that there was kind of like a tulip fever of Titanite in Lordran once they found the legendary slab, or once they found a chunk or something, they looked for the legendary slab. So I think all the heads of these demons are cut off because they are using them for Titanite and stuff. Oh my god. Oh my god. Sorry, I had something in my throat. Wow, the greed. The greed was real with that one. Well, now you get to watch me do that exactly again. If you want, I can tell you the story about the demonite. Monsters or whatever, demons. Yeah, these are called demons too. I don't know if that's an official name, but demons seem to be associated with, Izalith and the Chaos. These don't seem to me to be birthed from that whole process. So I don't know if they're true demons. Wow. Poorly planned there. What happened there? Pressed heal and then said no, like I didn't have any Estus left, but I did. Oh, come on. That was a waste of 72 damage. This has not been very effective at all. Ugh. You know, I already beat him once, I had my mind, so I'm like, not taking this part very seriously anymore. You let your guard down for a second, and, like, these trivial enemies, he's not trivial, it's a mini-boss, whatever. Oh my god, does that reach me? Okay. These trivial enemies start to matter, start to actually screw you up. Alright. No stamina, really great planning there. Weird AI. I I just did it again. Like, that was the exact same scenario, and had he not been, like, maybe pushed up on this broken pillar a little bit, I would have died again. So greedy. Anyway, we get Demon Titanite. So yeah, Demon. It is associated with Demon. Let's check out what that is. Special Titanite stolen from a faceless stone beast known as the Titanite Demon. When the nameless blacksmith deity passed from several slabs, great beasts arose. The power of Titanite remains within them, and they still roam Lordran today. So yeah, we have a blacksmith deity. We have a lot of deities. You know, we've learned about a couple, Old Man McLoyf, Allfather Lloyd potentially. We know about Gwyn. We're gonna learn about a couple more, and this is a nameless one, at least at the time being. And he must have worked with a bunch of the slabs, and these beasts certainly like became infested with them. But I still think they're probably involved with the obsession of Titanite all over the world, and their faces got ripped off or something. They're used to upgrade boss weapons, which, you know, there is a special blacksmith that makes boss weapons. This is an area that, oh, I don't have any more of these. These are little beings. They look to be made out of trees, although we'll see something later where, you know, it's kind of indicated that they at least came from another being that was not made out of trees. Although its legs really look like it's actually made out of trees, so that's weird. There's an item up there. But yeah, we're in Darkroot Garden here, and Darkroot Garden is a peculiar place. We do get these moss clumps from these guys, which are very helpful in later levels, which is a good reason to come here, at least kind of close to the beginning. Potently medicinal moss clump with a flower reduces poison and toxin. Restore status. Toxin is a more vicious form of poison. Moss clumps without a flower are useless against toxin, and a lack of these moss clumps could lead to an early demise. Toxic is no joke. Yeah, no. There's an interesting enemy down there. They look like, I don't know, like bottom feeder beings. I don't really know what they're called. There is a very large butterfly sitting right there. We're actually gonna go fight that. And I guess it's sitting up there, and we're gonna end up finding it on that bridge right there. We're gonna get there through this area. It's interesting because that's also a, the tower that you climb. And you can see if you look to the left, there's a bonfire here with no perceivable way of getting to it. I think, yeah, you can roll into that one. But yeah, you're supposed to know that because everything's crumbling and stuff. I don't know. So, we have this door here, which has this weird, magical, glowy thing. It seems to have the same particle effects on it that the butterfly has on it. But it says it's locked by some contraption, but I don't know, that's not usually what it means in later games, but yeah, apparently that's a contraption. There's a thing in here, I don't feel great about against the Stone Knight, so I'm going to wait to trigger that ambush for a little bit and just see where I'm at with the Stone Knights here. So yeah, on top of these weird people here, there's these Stone Knights that carry a form of magic here called Tranquil Walk of Peace, which we get much later in the game. Oh my gosh. From someone. But I thought I was backing into a different place. So yeah, if you don't know what's going on there, it kind of casts things so that you can't walk and you can't roll very easily and at all. But it's the magic is cast on him. So even though it affects me, it only applies when I'm close to him. So as he gets close, there's this little thing that surrounds me, that kind of holds me, and it goes away after a pretty short amount of time. And their stone sword and their stone shield, which he just dropped into the chasm of the world, are rare-ish drops and pretty good if you got strength going on. But they have interesting lore, which we'll read. There's this weird, there's these trees here, and then there's this weird snake. Oops. Started moving actually. So many crazy animals in the Darkroot Garden. I don't know if that has a name. We got a partisan. So I'm not sure if we had anything else new. No, I don't think so. Partisan probably doesn't have anything on it. It's probably just one of the low basic weapon types. Yeah. So, I don't need any of that stuff. What's also kind of interesting here is that there's, upon, you know, weird creatures, there's weird plant life here too. There's a tree that doesn't attack, although they had animations in the code for it, but it never got implemented. But you kill it and it was like some sort of illusion. It doesn't reappear again. And then we can go down here and find those weird stingrays or whatever, which drop. They drop the the grass or whatever. The stamina regeneration. Can't remember what it's called. It's interesting. These buildings, there's all these towers around here. Stone towers, they're crumbling. There's a little path up there. Get kind of ambushed by. Oh! This could be my demise. Just gotta wait for that to run off. Wow. Yeah, it's hard for this point in the game. I feel like I should try to get these smaller guys first here. Great. Doing really efficient work here. Stone guys, all that much. Okay. Probably heal just because he probably one shot me with that. As you can see now that he cast that on me and then he died, I can now move again. Stone greatsword. It's a pretty rare drop. Rare-ish. Stone knights who guard the Darkroot Garden wield this moss-covered greatsword. The same magic which created the stone knights is imbued in the sword. Unleash this power by wielding the sword with two hands. That would probably seem to imply that its strength is too great for most builds, 40. Yeah, you can still try it. Are one of these gonna give me a drop? There we go, green blossom, that's what I wanted to say. There's not a huge lore on it. Wait, did I pass it? Green weed, shaped like a flower. Temporary boost in stamina or cover speed. This unlikely bitter biting herb is sometimes harvested in large quantities, but normally is an annual plant found in the water. In the future Dark Souls games, there's quite a few plants that grow in water and stuff that have varying degrees of, like, there's like laws created around, not laws, but whether or not you can harvest them or not because they're so rare. There's another stone knight up here. At least he's alone. Can't attack them while they're standing up here. I staggered him out of casting the attack. I least getting back to this area isn't that difficult, but I don't like having to kill everything again once because I didn't get the Elite Knight set. I guess while I'm not leveling up vitality, I gotta at least be concerned with getting hit once or twice. I was gonna say, don't cast right there. This is not good. On the wrong side of him. I guess I'll get the wolf ring and I will. And let's pretend it never happened. Does he follow you? Well, I know they do. Alright, let's read this wolf ring description. Okay. One of the special rings granted to the four knights of Gwyn. The wolf ring belongs to Artorias, the Abysswalker. Artorias had an unbendable will of steel and was unmatched with a greatsword. I think I'll put that on. Not wearing anything at the moment. Okay. Trying to think whether or not I should fight. Oh, I should. Well, let's try to get the equipment here. I'm probably gonna die, so I might as well not turn human right away. I think magic does any damage to the Dark Reap Guardians people. For good reason. Yeah, I mean, like, my weapon's doing more damage, and, like, that's doing half of that damage. Or, not half, but certainly can. It's a brutal miracle. Right, now we just have to like kill all these people so we don't get ambushed. I'm interested that I can't hit that guy. get this stone giant, you know, a little bit out of the open. I mean, that's the problem with, you know, doing, I mean, you know, if I did more damage or whatever, it probably wouldn't be that big of a deal, but, you know, just this area right now just takes so long. I mean, I guess I could play, it just takes long for my build. I guess you could be someone that plays with a shield and stuff, and you just take their hits without moving or whatever, but I'm more of a dodgy thing, and that spell completely invalidates my playstyle, and I very much just have to wait it out. So this will probably be a boring episode. Thought that was moving again. Thought it was not in that close range. This always sucks because I always okay. He just happened to get stuck on a tree. Blood red moss clump. Well, you should read that one. Staggered him. Alright, what does this blood red one say? Red moss club reduces bleeding buildup. Bleeding builds up when attacked by sharp blades or spikes, and once triggered causes severe damage. Use the moss club until it reaches this point. I'm using a bleed weapon, and yet I wouldn't suppose I was, because it doesn't seem to be doing much of any of the additional attacks to them at this point, but I'll change. So the Elite Knight set is kind of cool. It's a bit heavy for me. How much do I weigh? 48, 24, 12. So I can only go to 12. And this is 11.7, so it's basically like, I mean, no, I don't want those. Well, let's read it. Helm of a nameless knight, perhaps an elite knight of Astora. Although he was loath to give up his undead mission, he perished at the undead asylum and went hollow. Well, that's strange, because he's here. Well, yeah, that's what Oscar of Astora was wearing, is the Elite Knight stuff. I guess in tradition of Miyazaki, we gotta put this on. Yeah, this is what Oscar was wearing at the beginning. He had the crest shield as well. Yeah, I'm just, it's not even slow roll, or mid roll, it's fat roll. But yeah, there it is. You gotta put it on once per playthrough. It's the rules, I guess. Oops. But nowhere close to doing enough damage. That's probably the other thing, too. I should be upping my endurance so that I can actually, like, carry more stuff. Oh, I did not mean to aggro this guy. Stone shield. Well, I really should have gone human there. I'll go human, and I want to attempt to summon as many people as I can, especially some of the more minor characters. Of course, all these guys are gonna come back here, hopefully I didn't do that too quick. I did. Alright, I'm gonna have to. Can't get up when you go too quickly, at least for me, it glitches like that.